Former Justice Secretary Attorney Estelito Mendoza has accused the Sandiganbayan of unwittingly redefining the plunder law in the case against his client, former President and now Pampanga 2nd District Representative Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Arroyo is facing plunder charges before the Antigraft Court over the alleged misuse of 365.9 million pesos Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office Fund when she was still President from 2008 to 2010. Mendoza said a public officer must have amassed, accumulated or acquired ill-gotten wealth of at least 50 million pesos to be charged with plunder. He said these were not proven in Arroyo's case. He added none of the 687 documentary evidences and 21 witnesses the prosecution presented showed Arroyo getting hold of, receiving or using a single peso from the PCSO fund.
The Sandiganbayan has actually created a new offense. It is not plunder. It is a creation of the Sandiganbayan only. That plunder is committed when the treasury is raided.
Arroyo's supporters also expressed disappointment at how the former president is being treated.
She has been treated just like a person who has been convicted. Essentially, therefore, since that time, she has been punished.
The one who is responsible is the court, which order detention. It is, and worse, if she dies in custody.
The release of the DAP funds, and as I said, that is worse, because the Supreme Court has already ruled that the DAP is unconstitutional.
Arroyo has filed an opposition to any extension of time for the Sandiganbayan to comment on the petition for certiorari filed before the Supreme Court. The Sandiganbayan First Division is supposed to release its comment on or before Monday. Meanwhile, Sandiganbayan Presiding Justice Amparo Kabotahitan said it's best to wait for the Supreme Court's definitive ruling on the matter. Caroline Bonquin, ABS-CBN News.